Welcome back, all my friends. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a pattern review of the Simplicity S9385, which is a pattern that is designed for jersey knit fabrics as well as sweater knit fabrics. I made several different versions of it, including mock-ups, and then my final version is made with this beautiful fabric here. And before we get started, I want to say thank you to Minerva for sponsoring me this fabric that I use for my final version. So this fabric is a black and white dotted jersey knit fabric. I'll make sure that I put the link to this fabric in the description box below, just in case you're wondering more about the contents of the fabric or you want to purchase the fabric. So let's go ahead and get into the video, and I'm going to tell you more about this pattern and then also the fabric as well. So the Simplicity S9385 come in two different size ranges. So you can purchase the 6 to 14 and then the 16 to 24. It has 10 pattern pieces and you have 4 different variations. The fabric suggestions are stretch knits such as jerseys, rib knits, stretch velvet, and sweater knit fabrics. This pattern have length variations as well as sleeve variations. So you can make a sleeve that has a gathering on the sleeve head, or you could just make a regular straight sleeve. You also have the option of doing a long cuff on the sleeve or a short cuff. And then also there's an option to do a band on the lower part of the garment as well. So I decided to do a combination of views B and C. So I did view C sleeve with view B's band, the lower band, and then also the neck band. And I did this for all of the versions that I made simply because I was trying to get the right fit for my final version. And so in the future, I would definitely make the gathered sleeve head. It's just, I was just focusing on trying to get the right fit for this particular garment. And now that I have the right fit, later on, I'll go back and do the version with the gathered sleeve. So the variation that I did, the very first variation for this, like I said, is view B with view C sleeve and then the cuff and the lower band. And then I made that with a really lightweight fleece type material. And so it's a knit, but it has a fleece backing. So it's a jersey knit. Not a jersey knit, it's some type of sweater knit that has a fleece backing on it, and I purchased it from Walmart, and so that's why I'm kind of confused as to what the actual contents of the fibers of the fabric are. But I do know it has a fleece backing, and I'm pretty sure it's a sweater knit of some sort. It's very comfortable to wear. I was able to get 3 yards of this for $8, and I purchased this with the sole purpose of doing mock-ups, and they turned out really well, and so I decided to keep it. So the very first variation, like I said, of this blue version, and I'll pop that here so you can see what it looks like, the neck band on it gapes a lot. So I had to take out 2 inches for the neck band because the neck band was way too long to go around the neckline of this. So when I say it was too long, it actually fit the neckline perfectly. And your neckband is not supposed to fit your neckband, your neckline perfectly. You're supposed to stretch your neckband as you're sewing, so that way it can close in and lay flush against your neckline. As you can see with the first variation, that did not happen because I had to decrease the length of the band. However, I didn't do it perfectly, and so there's still a little bit of gaping on that first variation, the first make that I made. So for the second make that I made it with a navy blue rib knit fabric, and this again was purchased from Walmart, but I purchased this years ago, so it was in my stash, and I decided to go ahead and use it. It's a really nice quality fabric, even though it's from Walmart, and it's very comfortable and warm. So I decided to see what it would feel like with the rib knit fabric as well. And then also each fabric, it behaves a little bit differently. And so you're going to get a different type of garment with this and a different drape depending on what type of fabric that you use. And I noticed that especially with this jersey knit fabric, and I'll tell you about that here in a moment. And the arm area, specifically around the lower band, you'll see that there is some extra fabric there, and it just looks, you know, very, very loose down in that area. And then the same is true down in the midsection area as well. It's very loose and very drapey in that area as well, and that's the nature of the fabric. I also believe that the pattern is somewhat supposed to fit like that as well. And so that's the kind of style that this particular pattern is going to give you. It's a loose fitting style. And I was going for something like that anyway, because I want my sweaters to be kind of loose and not too close fitting. So I was really happy with the actual fit. So the size range that I actually chose for this project is a 16, and I did a 16 through and through, except for the armhole area. The armhole, I went up a size and I did a bicep adjustment because I did sleeve C, and that's the close fitting sleeve. If I would have did the gathered sleeve, I would not have had to make a bicep adjustment, but since I did the straight sleeve, I had to make a bicep adjustment, and that bicep adjustment I believe was 1.5 inches. And so I did go up to the size 18 in that armhole area. So, but everything else is a size 16. So you'll see with the navy blue rib knit version, it's still, the neckband is still not quite flush against my neckline. And so I went back and I decreased it even more for this version that I'm wearing, because I am really particular when it comes to my neck bands, and it took me about 4 times to get the length of the neck band right, but that's okay. I finally got it right, and I really like the way that it is laying flush against my skin here. Now, I will tell you, there are a couple things that I had to do in order to achieve this, not just decrease the length of the band, but also the width of the band. The width of the band was just way too wide. And so I took about 7/8 of an inch of that off of the width of the band. So you'll see that this band is a little bit thinner than the first and the second versions. And I figured that that was another reason why I was getting some gaping, because the band was just way too wide for this particular style. This neckline is more suitable for the turtleneck than for views A and B. And I think that's why I was getting this frumpy neckline. So I think there was a couple of things contributing to that. And like I said, the first is that the neck band was too long. The second might be that I needed to go down a size for my neckline, because it just seems like this is this neckline is a little bit too long for me, and then also the neckband was too wide. So there is a couple of things there working against me, and so that's why I had to keep working on it and working at it to kind of figure out what was going on. So anyway, that's the only thing, the only problem that I had with this particular pattern. And I wouldn't say that it was actually a problem. Like I said, with flat patterns, with commercial patterns, you run into those types of issues and you just, you know, make those changes and you move on. So I wouldn't say it's a big issue. I really do highly recommend the pattern. It's a really beautiful pattern, and especially if you are not looking to make a lot of changes because it's very loose fitting, I think it would be a really great pattern for beginners and advanced beginners. All right, so let me go ahead and talk about this version that I am wearing. So I really like the final version and how it turned out. I'm so glad that I stuck with trying to get the neckline right, and then also the sleeves as well, because I feel like this is a really great garment and it's really nice for fall. It's really great and comfortable to throw on. And so I'm really happy with the fit. So other changes that I made to the final garment, I had to do a sloping shoulder adjustment. And I did, I think, about a 3/8 of an inch or 1/2 of an inch sloping shoulder adjustment. And then I also had to raise the shoulder point up as well. This shoulder line, I had to raise it up because it was dropping. And that's another thing I want to say about the pattern, is that I believe that this is a drop shoulder style. At least it seems like it is, because I had to lift that up quite a bit. I had to raise that shoulder point up quite a bit. But it's a really fun pattern, like I said, and it's easy, definitely for your beginners and advanced beginners. And it took me about 2 hours to complete this project. So for each one that I did, it took about 2 hours to cut the pattern, to trace the pattern, to cut the fabric and sew the fabric. So not including washing and all that stuff, all the other prep stuff, but it really was very simple and easy to do each one of these garments. And so it's not a bad pattern. I really like it, even though you do have to look out for the neck band and then also for that drop shoulder. If you are not wanting a drop shoulder or a drop sleeve, then I would say make sure that you pay particular attention to that, especially if you have a very narrow shoulder. Now, I have a broad shoulder, so I didn't have to raise it too much, but someone who has a very narrow shoulder, I would definitely say make sure that you watch out for that, because you might definitely need to raise it if you're not looking for a drop shoulder. So that was my experience sewing the S9385. I had fun making all these different versions of this top, and I am excited to do the version with the gathered sleeve head, and I will keep you all posted. If I make that one, I'll definitely keep you all posted and let you know what that one sews up like. So yeah, I really like this pattern and I highly recommend it. That wraps up my review of the Simplicity S9385. Thank you all for tuning in and hanging out today. If you have any questions or comments about this particular pattern or anything on this channel, make sure that you leave your comments in the comment section below. I hope you all have a happy and blessed Wednesday and stay creative. Bye.